Learning outcome. After studying this module, you shall be able to know what are document. You shall be able to learn the features of proving the authenticity of a document. And you will also identify the types of question document. Document. The term question documents covers a variety of different evidentiary questions which extends well beyond the traditional field of identification of question handwriting. It is commonplace nowadays to find the question document examiner being asked to determine questions of authenticity in regards to not only question signature but also to examine question typewriting, inks, writing instruments, paper, alterations of documents, eraser or other obliterations, and to determine the relative date of particular writing. Question documents are usually submitted for examination purposes in as much as doubts have been raised concerning their origin, authenticity, age, author, circumstances under which the document may have been executed. Within the field of forensic science, the scientific examination of document has one purpose: to provide information about the history of a document for the benefit of court of law, or before that to an investigating police officer or other agent seeking evidence that might be present in the document. The same philosophy that pervades the forensic science applies to the document examination. The application of scientific method and techniques to the problems relevant to the situation. The information contained in a document can be considered as occurring at two levels. The superficial, where which is conveyed to the document and expressed in writing, typewriting or printing, or a combination of any of these. And at a deeper level, where other less obvious evidence can be found. It is in the later field, which is the province of the document examiner, where information about the identity of writer, the source of the typewriting or printing, the presence of traces of erased entries and many other factors can be discovered. The significance of such discoveries can be interest to the many people in different occupation, but it is when document contain incriminating information that their origin are the concern of investigating officer and later of the courts. If a document is not what it seems, but once more information now removed to alter or the recite it carries in itself will be vital interest to a civil or criminal court. It is for these reasons that more scientific examinations of document are carried by forensic document examiners. Those whose conclusions are put before the court as written statement or given orally as expert evidence. Materially properly produced from a document by comparing it with one or more other documents can provide invaluable evidence on which a judge or jury may reach a decision. A connection between a crime and an individual or the exclusion of that individual from the investigation can be established. The principle involved in all these comparisons is that same as already referred in other branches of forensic science, the testing of various parameters and references to the background knowledge of the subject in order to reach a conclusion. Similarly, information can be deduced from a document by methods other than comparison, by the exploration of methods that detect more than the eye can see, facts that are valuable to an investigator or to court law and can be obtained. Now let us learn about the legal definition. A document in general can be defined as anything which can record or capture any event or thing so that the information is not lost. Usually a document is written, but a document can also be made with pictures and sounds. A document generally sticks to some convention centered on comparable or former documents or definite requirements.
A few common examples of documents are sales invoices, wills and deeds, newspaper issues, individual newspaper stories, oral history recordings, executive orders, product specifications, etc. The word document is a vast topic covering writing with any material such as pencil, pen or ink, or with any object on any material, example, a paper inscription, engraving on a metal plate, stone slab or any other material, typewritten, cyostyled, printed, lithographed, photographed matter, chart map, plane, etc. Due to the increasingly sophisticated advances in the automatic production of the documents, both in the office and in financial institutions, there has been a dramatic change in the typical casework problems presented to the document examiner. In the future, of document examiner will have to be more familiar with the increasingly complex technology regarding everything from optical character readers and laser printers to desktop publishing software and computer enhancement of blurred or distorted images. The identification of question handprinted or handwritten communication is based upon whether there exists sufficient individuality within the writing, or whether there are adequate known exemplars of the suspect to reveal those unique characteristics useful for identification purposes and also to indicate the natural variation of the writer. As an individual progresses beyond his formal penmanship training, he will diverge more and more from the so-called copybook system, which he was taught, and will start injecting his own personality within his writing and thus permit its identification through examination of his individual writing habits. It is the individual habits rather than the class characteristics which permit an expert to identify the author of a particular writing. The more the writer deviates from the traditional copybook standards of writing, the more value a specific trait has for identification purposes. It is therefore essential that a document examiner have the knowledge of both the domestic and foreign handwriting systems to preclude undue weight being attributed to a foreign element within the writing that may be related to a particular handwriting system and not a unique identifying trait. Both Indian Evidence Act and Indian Penal Code define documents. Indian Evidence Act. According to Section 3 of Indian Evidence Act 1 of 1872, a document may be defined as: document means any matter expressed or described upon any substance by means of letters, figures, or marks, or by more than one of those means intended to be used or which may be used for the purposes or recording that matter. Illustrations. A writing is a document. Words printed, lithographed, or photographed are documents. A map or plane is a document. An inscription on a metal plate or a stone is a document. A caricature is a document. Next is Indian Penal Code. Section 29 of Indian Penal Code defines documents as: the word document denotes any matter expressed or described upon any substance by means of letters, figures, or marks, or by more than one of those means intended to be used or which may be used as evidence of that matter. Explanation 1. It is immaterial by what means or upon what substance the letters, figures, or marks are formed, or whether the evidence is intended for or may be used in a court of justice or not. Illustrations: a writing expressing the terms of a contract, which may be used as evidence of the contract, is a document. A check upon a banker is a document. A power of attorney is a document. A map or plan which is intended to be used or which may be used as evidence is a document. A writing containing directions or instruction is a document. Explanation 2. Whatever is expressed by means of letters, figures or marks are explained by mercantile or other use shall be deemed to be expressed by such letters, figures or marks within the meaning of this section, although the same may not be actually expressed. Illustration: a writer's his name on the back of a bill of exchange payable to his order. The meaning of the endorsement as explained by mercantile use is that the bill is to be paid to the holder. The endorsement is a document and must be construed in the same manner as if the words "pay to the holder" or words to that effect had been written over the signature. Now let us learn about question document. A question document is defined as the document whose authenticity is challenged on a number of grounds, or a document or a part of document become a question document when its source of origin is doubtful or under question. Such documents are also known as disputed or contested documents. Qualified document examiner often represent themselves as experts, but unfortunately do not have the variety of training, experience or professional standards required of a forensic document examiner who was trained in a certified crime laboratory. Oftentimes, the so-called handwriting experts are self-taught or have received some sort of diploma or certificate of completion from a graphological organization, but do not have the diversified training required to answer the more complex documents problems facing most forensic document experts today. In this country, the term graphology basically involves the study of personality and character through an interpretation of handwriting traits. Many document examiners do recognize the importance of an individual's physiological state of mind and its possible adverse effects on the handwritten product, but historically steered clear of working closely with psychiatrists, linguists or psychologists in understanding the interaction of impulse and motor responses. The understanding, however, of the role of personality in the handwriting is a far cry from the identification of those individual character traits which graphologists traditionally have advertised as a primary vocational objective. Now let us learn about the authenticity of the document. No other instrument of crime seems to be as pervasive in our society today as the document. Forged check, security and exchange fraud, tax fraud, forged or altered wills, counterfeiting, embellishments and fraudulent transactions and financial crimes are all examples of potential document crimes. Fortunately, over the past few decades, continuing scientific research in the field of question document has developed more efficient methods for detection of fraud. Recent advances by forensic ink chemists have more readily permitted both the identification of the questioned ink sample as to the manufacturer and also the relative date of the ink based upon its solubility components. Additionally, there have been instrumental methods developed for the examination of obliterated, intended, erased, and charged documents, which will be discussed further. There can be many instances where the authenticity of the document is challenged. Let us discuss few such situations when the authenticity of the document is or can be challenged. First is when signature or thumb impression on the document are not genuine. The document defied with regard to the genuineness of the initials or thumb imprint of the executed or that of the attesting witness sets up the largest number as being the question document. Several times person denies their signature or thumb impressions, and on the basis of this we can categorize the document, that is genuine or forged, when the executant is required to admit or to deny the signature or thumb impression on a document is dispute. He generally denies his signature on the document by assuming that if the signs are admitted, the subjects of the document will be verified, which may go against him. Thus, in these cases, executant may claim that he does not know the script in which the signature under dispute are made, or that he is an illiterate person. On the other hand, it is not rare that documents created by forging the signature so as to cheat or claim benefits from those individuals whose signatures have been forged. Second is, if signature is admitted but the subject matter is challenged. A clever forger prepares documents by using signature obtained on blank paper by trickery or by using the available blank space above the signatures on the same other document and then tearing off the portion containing previous writing. In this way, the matter of the document becomes challenged or the whole document becomes question document. Next is, if there is any alteration in the document, then also document is questioned. The document which are alleged to have been altered by removing some matter or by erasing or by the addition of words, strokes or lines in the blank spaces or by replacing or altering by deletion or addition of strokes or letters. These are also sometimes defied on the foundation of consecutive order of entries, identity of pen and ink, alteration in amount, obliteration, sequence of writing or typewriting on a paper that has been folded to check whether it was folded after or before the writing. Next is, photocopies and carbon copies are also challenged documents. Sometimes the photocopies and carbon copies of document are challenged by claiming that the produced documents are not the real ones. Some changes have been done in photocopy by adding or deleting some of the portion of writing during the process. Nevertheless, these types of cases are very rare. Next is anonymous letters. Anonymous letters are also the type of question document in which letters are returned to the victim for blackmailing and threatening due to writer's disputed sex condition, love failure, family rivalry, religious, political prejudice or any other reason. In these cases, the document examiner is asked to determine the authorship of such anonymous letter by comparing the writing therein with writing of suspect. Next is, if the document is challenged on the basis of age of document. This class of document includes those documents in which the age of document or a part of document or the sequential order of various parts of documents are questioned. In such cases, the chief task of document examiner is to determine the age of document and to ascertain whether the document is actually older or not, as it purports to be. The cases of backdating documents are not uncommon. The varying sequence of strokes on the basis of revenue stamps documents are termed as forged or invalid. Now let us learn about preliminary examination of question document. An examination of a disputed document is a scientific problem and it is no longer confined to comparison of signature or writing, but it also includes examination of ink, typed matter, printed matter, watermark, and all other elements that combine together to form a document. The examination of a document is not complete until its every element has been studied and examined thoroughly. Points which are generally considered in preliminary examination are: is the paper of unusual size and was it cut or trimmed by hand or by margin? How many times the paper has been folded and what is the sequence of folds? Does the paper bear any marks of artificial aging and has the paper been torn, weighted, mutilated in any way? And if so, then what are the probable reasons? Does the paper bear indentation marks on the front side or embossed strokes on the reverse side? Does the paper show any physical or chemical erasing, obliteration, substitution, or alteration of any kind? Was the document written or typed before or after the paper was folded? Was more than one kind of ink or pens used to write the body writing of the document? Does the document show any unnatural spacing between the written or typed lines? Is the body writing of document written is continuity by one and the same writer? Any unusual feature, etc. Forgery owes its origin to the inborn tendency in human being to imitate, to which we may trace all arts finds or useful. Its detection is possible through another trait known as inherent quality of imperfection attending all human acts and performance. The counterfeit looks alike but doesn't reach up to the genuineness. It would be more true to say that nature repeats itself than to ascertain the contrary. According to Section 73 of Indian Evidence Act, in order to ascertain whether a signature, writing, or seal is that of the person by whom it purports to have been written or made, any signature, writing, or seal admitted or proved to be satisfaction of the court to have been written or made by that person may be compared with the one which is to be proved, although that signature, writing, or seal has not been produced or proved by any other purpose. The court can summon any individual to write words or figures for the purpose of comparison of sample documents with the questioned ones. Thus, The courts are authorized to compare the disputed writing with the specimen and form their opinion. But if the judges or magistrate have never studied anything about the scientific examination of handwriting, or no skilled expert is available to help them with reasoning, they may feel at loss. The comparison of handwriting and evidence of specially skilled specialist is allowed under Section 45 of Indian Evidence Act, which states that when the court has to form an opinion upon a point of foreign law or of science or art, or as to identity of handwriting or finger impressions, the opinion upon that point of person specially skilled in such foreign law, science or art, or in questions are to identity of handwriting or finger impression are relevant fact and admissible in court. To understand the natural phenomena, certain principles which have been established after long practice and experience should be followed, and these principles will enable the individual better to come to realities. To the inexperienced eyes of a layman, the production of cost by weaving inwardly or outwardly of a line will have no other significance than irregularity in drawing or writing. But to an experienced and educated specialist, these production and condition occurring in them will be indicative of the results of the muscular change that a person has attained after a long practice.
Summary: a document is any written material, but a document can also be made with pictures and sounds. Section 3 of Indian Evidence Act defines the document as any matter expressed or described upon any substance by means of letters, figures or marks, or by more than one of the means intending to be used or which may be used for the purpose of recording that matter. According to Section 29 of Indian Penal Code, the word documents denotes any matter expressed upon any substance by means of letters, figures or marks, or by more than one those means intended to used or which may be used as evidence of that matter. To prove the authenticity of the document, it is important for the admissibility of the document. According to Section 73 of Indian Evidence Act, in order to ascertain whether a signature, writing or seal is that of the person by whom it purports to have been written or made, any signature, writing or seal admitted or proved to be satisfaction of the court have been written or made by that person may be compared with the one which is to be proved, although that signature, writing or seal not have been produced or proved for any other purposes. The court may direct any person present in court to write any words or figures for the purpose of enabling the court to compare the words or figures so written with any words or figures alleged to have been written by such person. The examination of a document is not complete until it is every element has been studied and examined thoroughly, which may need an expert opinion. The comparison of handwriting and evidence of specially skilled specialized is allowed under Section 45 of Indian Evidence Act, which states that when the court has to form an opinion upon a point of foreign law or of science or art, or to identify handwriting or finger impression, the opinion upon that point of person specially skilled in such foreign law, science or art in question as to identify the handwriting or finger impression are relevant fact and admissible in the court.